the fundamental foundation of what I do. I've learned this in my 30s. And guys, I spent 10 years of my life making mistakes. I spent 10 years of my life in family corporate. I spent 10 years of my life in bankruptcy. And here's the one thing that I realized. If I didn't have this, even if I rebuilt it all over again, I would eventually lose if even I was going to rebuild if I don't have this one thing. And what is that? That's faith. Faith. I wrote a book about it. It's called Faith Made Millionaire. I don't credit to what I do because of me. Even my team, I'm not self-made. I'm not even teammate, even though that's great. Even team over self. But it was over us. And the whole evolution of our process is faith. Faith made us. Instead of fake it to make it, I faith it to make it. And faith is a blueprint. When you look at this book, when I see 6,000 years of human history inside this manual, inside this book, the Bible, this is why I look at the Bible. It's just not a bunch of hymns and a bunch of boring scriptures. To me, this is a blueprint to how to go through some of the worst things about what a human being goes through and how to come out on the other side blessed, squared away, and being a blessing to other people. But it is the blueprint for me to guide my decisions through wisdom and discernment. And what is wisdom? Here's what I'll share about this. Wisdom to me is not just knowledge. I run across a lot of knowledgeable people all the time. College degree, master's degree, PhD, but zero common sense. Zero world experience. Zero done it themselves. And yet they want to counsel me just because they read about it in a book, that because they think they're more credentialed or qualified than me because they have a piece of paper that proves it, because they put $100,000 into their college education, and that justifies why their perspective is much richer and read up and a better viewpoint than mine, who's a kid from Chicago with a 2.2 GPA, 8 years in the Marines, 25 years of experience dealing with people, building a $40 million top-line revenue type company. You don't think that has some form of parallel value to as well outside of just an academic degree, an academic education? So when I look at somebody with education, I ask the next question is, who have you learned from that actually is in the grind with practical experience and actually doing it? Because the key word there is experience. If you can combine education, academia, with experience, woo! Now you got wisdom. And sometimes you don't need to necessarily be in academia to be educated. But if you're educated, whether through academia or street smarts, with experience, boom, that's wisdom to me. So when you're looking at that blueprint, here's some videos here. We'll have some reaction on what that is all about. Let's take a look at this.
What's your thoughts on faith, and how does a man build his faith?
You don't have to build it. You have to understand you were born with it. I'm not talking about your religion. I'm talking about your faith. We both share, you know, we're both Christians, I know, but I don't tell people what to believe. So without faith, we don't function, but faith is a muscle. And the more you use a muscle, the stronger it gets.
Amen.
Faith unused does not grow, it shrinks. Courage unused does not grow, it shrinks. Passion unexpressed does not grow, it shrinks. So, but if you use more of it and you rely on it more, you discover it's there.
By the way, if the more you're skeptical, the more you're cynical, the more you look at the world in a negative way, that grows too. So when you're looking at your faith, you can either feed your fears all day, and guess what? That grows. And what a strong monster that is. I would even argue that fear is a much better recruiter than faith. I would say that anger, and I'm going to do me, I'm going to be isolated, I'm going to be stuck in my man cave, is a much more attractive proposition than getting out of your shell, transforming, being vulnerable, being worked on, being honed on in faith.